Hi everyone, this is Jason here from Nathaniel. In this lesson, we're basically going to study a very important left-hand arpeggio technique, or a pattern if you will, which can be used for a lot of music. It can be used for music which pretty much is on a 4x4, anything on 4, and anything which doesn't sound too dancey or jumpy or groovy. It'll also work in an event where you want to play something in the right hand, like the melody line, and you want to support that melody line. And what better than, you know, chords, and obviously chords played with some really nice arpeggios. So what you heard in the introduction video was where I just took a simple chord progression, which is 4 chords. I'm going to show you that shortly. And then you play this arpeggio pattern, a very free-flowing, you know, system. And then over this, you kind of play melodies. And if you do stick around till the end of the lesson, which I sure hope you do, we are going to look at how to play the piano theme song from the French movie Amélie, which goes something like... right? This one. Which will work on the same chord progression. Right? Stuff like that, you know. And we'll also look at the theory behind it and the logic behind it, and how melodies can be composed also given an existing chord progression. So it all starts with a chord progression which you're going to play in the left hand, following a really nice arpeggio technique, a go-to technique which can be used for pretty much any genre, any melody which goes on here. You find the chords, play them in the left hand, arpeggiate them nicely using this technique, and you're good to go. And then you focus exclusively on the melody and whatever you need to improvise. So before we dive in, perhaps if you haven't already, do give the video a like, leave us a comment at the end of the lesson for something you'd like to learn, share the video with your friends, and do not forget to hit the subscribe button and that notification icon for regular updates whenever we do a new lesson. Okay, so the chords, it's a 4 chord progression: E minor, G major, then you go B minor and D major. I repeat, E minor, playing it in the left hand, G major, then you go B minor and D major. Okay, now the first concern with these chords is if you play them the way it is, the way they are written down in normal books, in the block system, you'll find that E minor is E, G, B, and then G major is G, B, D. So you have to jump a long way to play these chords, and thus you would need to know your inversions. Inversions, in a nutshell, what's going to happen is you play your E minor, and then when you do have the next chord, G major, make sure you don't jump too much. Rather, figure out, is there something in common? In this instance, there are 2 notes in common. There's G and B. So the upcoming chord, G major, will be G, B. Retain the position. Don't change those fingers. What is the remaining note now in the G major chord? That's D. Now, you don't want to play D there. That'll look really awkward. So instead of this E, it gets replaced by B. Sorry, it gets replaced by D, which is just played down a step. E, G, B, D, G, B. And D, G, B is nothing but the G major right there, right? So E minor, G major, the second chord. Now the third chord is B minor. Again, we don't want to jump all over the place to play the B minor chord. Rather, we play it this way. What's in common between B minor and the preceding chord G major? You'll find that B and D, or D and B, are common. So only thing which has to change is G, which changes itself to F sharp. That creates the B minor. What do we have so far? E minor, G major, B minor, and lastly D major. And you're already seeing it here. D major is D, F sharp, A. B minor has already given you 2 of those notes, D, F sharp. So the only thing remaining is A, and you slide the thumb down or add some other finger and play the D major chord. So the 4 chords: E minor, G major, B minor, D major, Okay, and now coming to the arpeggio pattern in order to play these chords. So I'll play you the arpeggio pattern and then demonstrate it for you. So it goes. As you can see, it's a very consistent pattern. So if I just show you over the E minor chord, it'll be E, B, G, B. So how do we kind of translate that to all the other chords? You go low, high, middle, high. In terms of what you're seeing and what you're hearing in terms of pitch, this is the low note, high note B, middle note G. So if this is your chord hold, low, middle, high. And the pattern we are proposing for the left hand is L, H, M, H, L, H. Okay. Keep that going. And then apply it for the next chord, which is G major. Once you're done with that, do it for the next chord. B minor. Same thing, L, H, M, H. And then D major. Okay, and don't overplay the chord. So just do everything over a bar of 8 eighth notes. So that'll be 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. So you do L, H, M, H into 2 cycles. So L, H, M, H, L, H, M, H. So L, H, M, H. Change. Keep it nice and slow. B minor. D major. Repeat. Add some dynamics, make it a bit loud, drop it, up, drop. Dynamics basically means volume control. So you need to set the bass, set a solid foundation for what's to come, which is the right hand, right? So you should play the left hand in a very, you know, autopilot kind of way, you know. Also, as you can see, I'm talking to you while playing this. So it means that there is some kind of confidence being developed in this particular hand. Because ultimately, you can't think of two things at the same time, you know. It's very difficult, even in day-to-day life, I guess. So one thing is pre-programmed, which is this. So you need some time on this. It's going to take you a little bit of time. And then we need to slowly bring in the melody line in the right hand. So I have a lot of approaches towards producing the melody in the right hand. I'm just going to share them with you. These are just melodic improvisation techniques. So in addition to that left hand, I figured we might as well also have some fun in the right hand. This video shouldn't just be about one hand. You don't leave a piano lesson without talking about both hands. So first off, in the right hand, the first technique or the first approach would be look at the chord tones of every chord. In this case, E minor has E, G, B. And just play those chord tones. Start with maybe E. Hold it. Maybe now you could try G.
G.
B.
B.
E. You could also try some other notes.
F sharp.
Sounds more colorful, but there's some notes which just won't sound good, like
B flat.
Not too bad actually, but you get the idea. You want to just play on the chord tones to start off with, you know, and a simple triad, three note chord structure. So first thing you could do is get acquainted with the notes of each chord. You know, just play them like that, hold it. And then we can be a bit more adventurous. We can just take one note. Play it a bit more. Maybe a rhythm. You don't have to play octaves. You can just do single notes. Something like that. Improvise with just those three notes. when you change the chord. B minor. And just take one note. Basically, one note per chord, two notes per chord, or three notes per chord, which is all the notes of the chord, and explore those notes either higher or lower on the piano, and work on some rhythm pattern before you play anything on the keyboard if you want some rhythmic interest or a rhythmic challenge for your hand independence skills, you know, with left hand and right hand, because the left hand has to hold its ground while the right hand will keep exploring. And right now you're just exploring over the chord tones. Right, so apart from the chord tones, let's look at another way to kind of melodically improvise in the right hand while holding your ground in the left hand, playing pretty much the same progression. And just for your information, the chord progression has originated from the minor scale, from the E minor scale. Derived from the G major scale, of course, 1 sharp, F sharp. So all your melodic elements will tend to come from the scale, and so will the chordal elements. So coming to the right hand, another option which you can do is improvise around the pentatonic scale, which, as I always say, is an anything goes scale. So you can use this scale along with any chord progression, you know, within the scale. It kind of really works. Let me just show you what I'm talking about and then break it down. Something like this. Five notes. So pentatonic scale will be E, G, A, B, D. You can add the final octave D. E, G, A, B, D, E, D, B, A, G, E, B. It's a great scale to kind of just shred away and, you know, and build very catchy phrases and very catchy, long-lasting melodies like... Now, when you play the pentatonic scale, you can build it on any key. It's just the 1, 3 flat, perfect 4th, perfect 5th, minor 7th or flat 7. Or if you're doing it in this context, just remember the notes. E, G, A, B, D, E, E, D, B, A, G, E. Okay? So you're supposed to now improvise on the pentatonic scale in the right hand and play the same chord progression in the left hand, which I'm calling the Amelie or chord progression, which is from the movie. This is the piano theme song of that movie, right? Which you should definitely check out. So it goes... pentatonic. Or stick just in one shape. Okay, so that's about the pentatonic scale. So we've looked at chord tones, pentatonic scale. How else can you improvise in the right hand? Well, a great way to improvise is to see what you have within yourself, first of all, you know, by singing. Singing is the most unfiltered way of bringing your thoughts out on the piano. So play the chord progression, play the regular chord progression, and hum a phrase. And you don't have to play it real time. You can hum a phrase and then proceed towards trying to play what you sung. For example, and again, on the scale or even on the pentatonic scale is fine, but you will not leave the scale in any case. So it's very rare because the chords are inspiring you to sing diatonically or within the scale elements. So let's see. Da da de, da da. Keep it simple. Just that. La da de, da da do. Ba-de-de-de-de-de-de-doo.
da-dee-da-da. Ba-da-da-da-da-dee. Ba-da-da-da-dee.
Right? So, in some instances, you could practice this by singing and then playing, like a call and response. Sing a bar, play a bar, right? Actually, that is a great way to practice, come to think of it. And after a while, you could just sing. You could forget the piano for a while. Just sing and see what all you can come up with. Maybe keep a cell phone recorder on so you can keep documenting your work as you go along and maybe work on that on the piano. And you've sort of given yourself like a finger exercise in one, a ear training exercise where you have to match up what you just sang, and even an independence exercise. So all the things of piano, all the departments of piano are sort of covered, you know, in that sense. So that's about call and response. That's another great way to get things going in your right hand. And what next? Another very, very simple thing before I move into an actual song, which is this Amelie theme for you, will be to just get a handhold of about three consecutive notes in the scale. Maybe E, F sharp, G. Three is nice. You can even do four. This is within the scale. So E minor. E minor is this, first of all. So you go sets of three, sets of four, or maybe sets of five. So, and now, go in another set of three, starting on F sharp. Start on G. It'll all sound decent because it's all part of the scale. So, then maybe sets of four. Yeah. You can even repeat that. So I've promised you a song as well, which you can do, right? So there are basically three sections in the song, right? This is the Amelie theme song. I'm just going to share maybe one section or a couple of them. I will do another video explaining this entire song. I think that would also be nice. But for now, the purpose of this video, if you remember from the start, was to get a great workhorse left hand arpeggio pattern, which will work on anything, a ballad, any melodic thing you do in the right hand, anything, whatever, which is actually, if I come back to it, was just this LHMH. So this is the point of the lesson, but let's just try and look at what we can do with the Amelie theme. So first off, first section is, okay, G, B minor. Okay, that's four parts. So first part, that's E, G, F sharp, G, B, C, B. Okay, that's over E minor. Then when you go to G, okay, from the beginning, right? Over the G, then very similar, so ending F sharp, E F sharp, back. Then okay, then that was just on pairs or just sets of threes or fours, as I showed you. And then it goes to like chord tones. So you go, they just do E, B, D, B. parts of the chord. F sharp, B, F sharp, A, something like this. So it goes, you can play it with octaves. Just highlighting the chord tones. Okay, and then what happens, you can also play it in thirds, you know. Basically thirds. So that's G with B, and then G with B, and then D with G, then you go F sharp over B, and then F sharp over D, and then, or you just do single notes, right? Right, so then it goes to that crazier part, which is, so what happens there, you basically divide your arpeggio into threes there as 16th note. So you go da 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 da. That's for E minor. But you have to figure out a way to keep this rocking, right? So you go sort of the chord tones, but this is 16th notes and over accents of 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 4. And you wait there. So stretch out your hand a bit for this. New chord. Because it's D major, you just play, sorry, because it's G major, you just play the G major chord tones here, but in that arpeggio. So then B minor, and then D major. You end with an interesting note, which is G. Let's do that again. G major, B minor, A, D major. Right, so that's a quick rundown of the Amelie theme song, which you can easily play along with this chord progression. Right, guys, so that's pretty much the lesson. What I wanted to share was a really rock-solid workhorse left-hand arpeggio rhythm, which you can use for anything, you know, even if it's major. Whatever you want to play. Whatever you like to play, really, you know, or just improvise, as we've also seen. So you can use this rhythm, LHMH. We've looked at a chord progression. And then we've also looked at, since we did not want to leave that out, this is not just a left-hand lesson. That would make the lesson rather boring. So in the right hand, what we ended up doing was five ways of embellishing the melody. The first off thing we did was just pretty much latch onto the chord tones. The second thing we did was jam on the pentatonic scale, which is that five note magic thing. Sounds good on anything, right? The third approach is make it more primal, sing, play, sing, play. And you'll be very surprised what's going to happen on the piano and how it can challenge you, you know, because when you sing, there's no filter. You just do whatever you feel like doing, you know. Then the fourth approach was shapes, those sort of things. And improvise over the hand shape. And last but not least, we just looked at and captured the essence of that Amelie theme song, which is played beautifully on the piano. I'm sure you've heard it. I'm sure you love it. Right, guys? So again, this is Jason here from Nathaniel. I'm going to sign off the lesson by just doing a little bit of improvisation over the chord progression. Stick around for a bit. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Turn on that bell. Subscribe to our Patreon for various notes and other stuff, which I'll be regularly putting up, and leave us a comment, leave us a thumbs up, share the video, blah blah blah. So let's get cracking with some improvisation.
Toodle.